In this video, I'm going to give you a quick tutorial so that you can go out there today and start finding potential products to sell on Amazon. Now, if you're new here, hello, my name is Nick and I've been a full-time Amazon seller for over 5 years now. I've sold over £2 million worth of products on the platform, and Amazon is a big part of how I make my money online. I've set up this channel to help pass on some of the lessons I've learned along the way. I've become very good at finding products to sell on Amazon. I've become very good at selling products on Amazon. So the hope is, by putting together this free tutorial for you, you're going to be able to learn and take some actionable information away today that can help you build your very own Amazon business. Now, we're using Helium 10 today as normal. As you'll see, I've got black box open. Now, a lot of people, when they're teaching you how to find products to sell on Amazon, will focus in on the products tab. It's not the worst tab on black box, but it's not the best. So I don't even bother. You know, you can go through categories and look for particular products, but I focus in on keywords because I'm looking at markets as a whole rather than particular products. So there's different ways to do it, but in my opinion, using the keyword method is far better because you get a bigger picture of what's going on. We'll start with the search volume. We're looking for keywords here that have a minimum of 6,000 searches a month. This is very important. I'm going to talk to you about the revenue bracket because you might see other people talking about, look, this product is doing $50,000 a month, $30,000 a month, and you might think that's brilliant. But if you're a brand new seller, you might not have the budget to jump into these markets straight away. As you'll also notice, I'm actually looking for product ideas on the US Amazon Marketplace. Now, I sell on Amazon Marketplaces all over the world, but the US has the best opportunity, in my opinion, because it's the biggest marketplace. If you are a complete beginner and you want to understand how you might be able to sell on a foreign marketplace from the country you live in, check out the video you can see at the top of the screen, because I give you instructions there based on my own experience, how you can set up an Amazon account and start selling over in the US, even if you live in the UK like me, or maybe the Netherlands, or wherever you are in the world. If your country is permitted by Amazon to set up an account, you can do it and sell overseas. That's what a lot of people do. We're looking here for product opportunities, but we don't want to go too high because we've only got a limited budget. Now, I normally say you need around 75% of your target monthly revenue in budget in order to launch that Amazon product successfully. Some people can do it for less, but that's a good rule of thumb I like to use. So we're looking for product ideas here that generate between $6,000 and we will go up to $12,000. Now, price again is quite important. Anything under $10, it's not really worth looking at. So we'll go for 12 all the way up to 40, because you might think, oh, I might not be able to afford a $40 product if I've got a low budget. But if you're not buying that many units, it can actually be a really good way to start slowly building your Amazon sales momentum. Now, I'm going to speed the rest of this up. We're looking for low reviews, so we're going for 350 reviews as a max. Word count, we want 2. And a few other important parts here. We want FBA and FBM. And with shipping size, we want to select all, but then remove any oversize, because it's just going to make it very, very expensive for us to import. So we can do that. I sometimes like to play around with the competing products. I'll put a max here of 600. Now, we can get started with this straight away. And we don't want to go after product ideas that are based around a brand specific keyword, because it's going to be very, very difficult for us to convince people to buy our products when they're actually going out and searching for a very particular brand. Now, let's keep going through. And all I'm going to do is, any good products I see, I'm going to open them up so that we can refer back to them. We've got reusable water balloons. I think that's pretty cool. Open that up and we'll refer back to it. And this is just a case of going through and finding things that don't look too seasonal, so I avoid anything with seasonal looking keywords in, but also things that don't look complicated. So I also like to avoid electronics. I like the look of this. This is a water absorbing stone tray, self-stirring coffee mug, that's going to be electronic. White willow bark capsules, that could be interesting. Disco ball planter, again, that could be quite interesting. Okay, Now, what you want to do is look for product ideas that aren't too complicated, that you can come in and bring out your own version. So if we look at a few of these in particular, I'll show you inside my mindset. Now, this is interesting. This is a niche I haven't seen before. People are making these hanging planters out of disco balls. Now, this is really interesting because actually I've seen a niche idea on Amazon for urban gardening. So people that live in cities, but absolutely love gardening, have a passion for it. And you can see how there's a market there that's not too big. It's quite niched down. Now, what I tell people all the time is find a niche and find a way to make yourself different and unique. Now, this is actually quite an interesting niche. Now, what I would be doing from this point is scanning through page one. And as we can see, all of these products look very, very similar. And I bet we can find a way to bring out our own version to actually make something completely unique. There's so many different ways you can do this. You don't have to specifically customize the product, although that's what I like to do. You can make a simple tweak with the color or packaging and really show that off in your main image. The whole aim of the game is when a customer is scrolling on Amazon, we want your listing to pop out and basically say to them, click on me. And that is the aim of the game. So I clicked on X-ray. This is another part of Helium 10. And if you want to use Helium 10, go down into the description and you can use one of my codes to save money. Don't, whatever you do, pay full price. I'll make a commission if you do that, but it does make it cheaper for you. That's why I do it. So if we have a look through here, we can see that there's a number of listings that are doing over $10,000 a month. And if we go over to reviews, they haven't got very many reviews at all. So what we would be doing from this point is opening up a few different comparable listings and looking through the review data to see if there's anything we can improve on that particular product experience. So also what I like to do to get an idea of what a product might cost is to look at the average revenue. Now, this isn't an exact science, and I go into this in far more detail, but usually if you want to launch a product, this is what I use as a rule of thumb. I might discount the highest selling product in the category, which, as you can see, there's one here doing $76,000 a month, but there's plenty of other versions here. And if we look at the average, it's $4,600 a month. So usually it's going to cost me 80 to 100% of this figure to buy my first round of stock, to send it into Amazon and to launch it. That is going to be my initial launch cost. And I always look to break even, make a little bit of profit on my first shipment. But it's pretty straightforward. It's a good rule of thumb. And it's what I use to sort of highlight and shortlist product ideas. So if you've got a particular budget, this is a great thing to do, because if you're looking, let's say you've only got $5,000 or $6,000 to launch a product, but you're looking at, you know, these products out there that are doing, on average, the four best sellers in the category are doing $30,000 a month. You're going to have to match their sales over the first 90 days in order to rank and to get to the top of page one. So it's just not a good strategy, because you're not going to have enough money, and ultimately you're going to invest a lot of money to launch your product and maybe fall at the last hurdle, unless you've done something really special with either your brand or your product. So look, another idea here are these sort of, what are they? They're instant sink drying sort of organizers. A very particular material. Again, this looks like quite a cool product idea. Now, I shortlist ideas from this point. I scan through, I'll make a list of them, add them into a spreadsheet, and then I'll go away, start looking at prices with suppliers, start thinking about ways I can make a difference, make something unique. And that's where we go into the review data and start to pick up ideas on how we can improve it. Now, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hopefully that's given you an introduction to Helium 10. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe if you want to learn more about how to do this. And I'll see you guys very soon in the next video.